Donald Trump doubling down on his support for profiling in the aftermath of the bombing in New York that injured 31 people. Here to discuss it, Dino Badala, the columnist for The Daily Beast, and Saba Ahmed, the founder of the Republican Muslim Coalition. Thank you so much for joining us. Dean, I'm going to start with you first.
Sure.
Donald Trump says our screening process is missing dangerous terrorists. Rahami got through secondary screening after spending time in Afghanistan and Pakistan. Does Donald Trump have a point?
Quick thing, first of all, I just want to say, as a Muslim, this attack is despicable. As Muslims, nobody wants to stop terrorists more than us, frankly, because these people define our faith wrongly and cause a backlash to our community. I hear people all the time say, I don't hear Muslims denounce it. I want to make it clear we do. Organizations across the country have. This man got in. You know, Donald Trump lies about something else. He says Muslims are not working with law enforcement, not turning people in. This man's father turned his son into the FBI, just like the shooter in Orlando was turned in by another Muslim in his mosque.
But what about his point about secondary screening?
Where the man was here for years. I mean, the guy was here for years. Forget secondary screening. We're talking about right now. The FBI clearly needs more resources. People are tipping off the FBI. You can't blame them. They need more resources so that when someone is tipped off, they can continue to follow them and prevent them from committing this. Both Orlando and this one could have been prevented with more resources with the FBI.
Okay, Saba, so he went and visited other countries and came back, and Donald Trump says secondary screening he was missed and that it needs to be better. Does he have a point?
Well, exactly. Anybody that's on the FBI radar list needs to be vetted and watched carefully. But at the same time, Donald Trump actually wants to be a president for all Americans, including Muslims. Irrespective of our religions, we have to be at the table and help Republicans and Democrats alike in solving national security problem. Trump is coming across really strong against terrorism, which is a good thing. We all want to see a safe, secure America. And I think having a president that understands national security and has Muslims on his cabinet or in his administration, it will send the right message and have good things for all Americans.
You're saying someone who understands national security?
I think Trump understands it. I think he understands the basis of terrorism, and I think he has the right intentions. He has good intentions in his heart, and I hope that he will continue his strong leadership. America doesn't need to weaken. If somebody is perverting the religion of Islam, they need to be held accountable. Islam strongly condemns terrorism, and that needs to be said. He's all for peace-loving Muslims all around the world. He has been talking even today. He was meeting with President of Egypt, assuring that he wants to support peace-loving Muslims, and we all want to join together in our fight against terrorism.
Okay, let's talk about, this was yesterday, he said he supported profiling based on ethnicity. Let's listen.
You go to Israel and they should study, because Israel's done a phenomenal job at this, and they profile. And they're not happy about it, but they do it. And people aren't complaining about it. But we have to profile. Honestly, whatever it is. But I'm not using the term Muslim. I'm saying you're going to have to profile. All right. We're going to have to start profiling.
So, Saba, as a Muslim who supports Donald Trump, do you think profiling Arabs or Muslims is a solution?
No, definitely not. But at the same time, religious profiling has to be done with caution. There has to be, you know, checks and balances. And unless Muslims are involved in the national security debate, then it's an open game, and they can target anybody that they want. And my issue with the whole administration just not even calling it out as Islamic terrorism is that we need to support people who are strongly working against it, and the voices are being such silent, and so what we get to hear is direct profiling and targeting of Muslims, which is not the right approach. Okay. We have to have Muslims within Trump administration to counter such narratives.
Dean?
First of all, Saba, with all due respect, I think Donald Trump is clueless about national security. His rhetoric is what ISIS wants to hear. Donald Trump says Islam hates us. ISIS says the West hates us. They're a mirror of each other. Donald Trump is going to help ISIS recruit. He's already helped al-Shabaab by using the idea. But one quick thing, Saba. I'm glad we both agree on the idea of profiling is wrong. It's unconstitutional. Donald Trump is literally calling for profiling of 2 million African-Americans, because that's how many Muslims that are African-American. They're the biggest group of our community. So Donald Trump tomorrow is going to go reach out to African-Americans in Cleveland at a black church while yesterday calling for profiling 2 million African-Americans.
And he has Muslims
it's
there
wrong,
with him.
It violates the Fourth Amendment, 14th Amendment. It violates our values. A real leader unites Americans. A person who's insecure and panicky, like Donald Trump, who is in desperation mode, is saying now we should deprive Muslims of our rights because of our religion.
Quickly, Saba, I have to get to break.
No, I think there will be Muslim Americans present tomorrow in Cleveland along with Donald Trump. I think we need to engage, step up our efforts. We need to have much more in common with the Trump administration. Clinton is providing weak leadership. We don't need that in the White House. We have seen that over the last several years, and it hasn't made any America any more safer.
All right, Saba and Dean, thank you very much. That's it for us tonight. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you right back here tomorrow.